the mirror and realized there was another figure that was not my own. Although aware of this girl, my mind didn't register her immediately, perhaps because she was so still. As I pondered whether or not to talk to her, simply for how ordinary and homely she looked, the girl looked directly at me, and I was shocked with how old and tired her eyes looked. As my brain debated whether or not to call out, my mouth said, "Hello? Hello?" When the girl didn't respond, I started to turn away, thinking it was all in my head, when the tiniest of voice seemed to come from the spot she was in. "You see me?" was all she said. Really, I rather thought that was a stupid question, but I continued to engage further. "I wouldn't have said hello if I didn't see you." She seemed to doubt what to say next, so I engaged further. "Are you okay? Do you need anything?" Nobody has said hi to me for a very long time. I was beginning to doubt that anybody could see me. "That's very strange," I said. "You're sitting right there. Why wouldn't anybody be able to see you or talk to you?" I had a pain in my heart a while back, and I had to stop and take a break and lean against something. "Yes? And then what happened?" People couldn't seem to understand why I just couldn't get up and get moving. "Couldn't you keep moving?" I asked. "No. Actually, I had to sit down. My heart was cracked and bleeding and in pretty bad shape. It still feels pretty raw and non-existent." The girl in the mirror felt torn, invisible for so long. People passing her by day after day, year after year, always feeling like something was wrong, like she was defective somehow. Maybe that's when her heart began to hurt. And finally, someone said hi, and she didn't know what to do next. She sensed this was the time to come back, but I happened to speak first. "I do sincerely want to know, are you okay? No, I'm not okay. I don't know why I'm feeling this way and I can't fix it. Perhaps, just because you're in the mirror, you could come a little closer and we could